The common ancestor of humans is referred to as a hunter-gatherer. This is a clear reference to a hybrid origin that is in plain sight for everybody to see, but which nobody really picks up on. In the animal kingdom, we find hunters and we find gatherers. We don't really find hunter-gatherers. Now, according to Stan Gooch, our ancestors, the ancestors of our hybrid origin, are Cro-Magnon man and Neanderthal man, or a type of Neanderthal man, because there were several Neanderthals around the world, as I've explained in the video about skull shapes. But there was only one type of Cro-Magnon. Now, Cro-Magnon is tall. He has a gracile figure, has smaller eyes. So he's a diurnal hunter, an athletic build. He uses weapons. He's a very skilled weapon manufacturer and tool manufacturer. The development of spears, better and better spears, and the spear thrower, the atalatl, would have precluded him being a long distance predator. So he would have hunted his prey over long distances. So a skilled hunter is somebody who can kill something from far away. That's what we still recognize that today in somebody. A hunter is able to kill his prey without the prey knowing that he's there. So we still have newspaper reports every time there's a war of the latest impressive sniper who's the Terminator or whatever he was called during the Iraq and Afghanistan conflicts, and he had 32 kills all from over a mile away or something ridiculous, a kilometer away or something like that. And then there was the airplanes that were dropping bombs down people's chimneys in the first Iraq war that they showed us footage of, and that was seen as something impressive. Maybe I'll touch on all of that another time, on why that's impressive and why it's what it's got to do with hunting. I suppose I could go into it now, actually. There are three things that are impressive to particularly men, but to humans in general, and these are the speed of something, the efficiency, and the response time. So with something like cars, you have the reading of how quick something accelerates. How responsive the car is. And its ability to be able to stick to the road or drive, in a sort of good direction. So a bad car would be a car that just skids off the road all the time or is uncontrollable at high speeds. So, and these are all the traits of being an ancestor of Cro-Magnon, because Cro-Magnon, being a hunter, had highly developed hunting instincts, which are obviously more marked in men than they are in women, and they're more marked in Europeans than they are in the rest of the world. These are traits that we admire in people. We admire them in sports, in athletes. We admire them in weaponry, in vehicles. We build sports around these three values, and they're all to do with hunting. So we've got a very rich history of hunting and a very rich ancestry of hunting, especially in Europe. But all humans are hybrids, so everybody has some of these things in different levels of ability, but in Europeans they're more refined or more respected, or something like that. So then the other half of our ancestry is the gathering. So we have the Neanderthaloid types, which have come out of Africa. So in Africa you have an abundance of environment where everything was available. There wasn't any need to develop hunting skills, really. Not really. There may have been some need to develop them. Probably more likely when Neanderthal entered Europe, and the what we call classical Neanderthal is in Europe, and is a different type of Neanderthal, but that's the one who has spears and hunts mammoths and stuff like that. But you don't really find as much of that in Africa or in the Far East. And they had larger eyes, so they were nocturnal. They had a picnic body type, so they were more squat. They had a lower center of gravity, so much more suited to foraging, much more suited to groundwork rather than running. They had a different heel structure to us and to Cro-Magnon, which meant that they couldn't run as well as Cro-Magnon could. They're much less gracile body than Cro-Magnon, and their tool technology isn't great. They appear to have mobbed up on their quarry or their prey, and chased whole herds of mammoths over the edges of cliffs to kill them all, and go and pick the bones at the bottom of the cliff. So they were much more crude in the way that they got their food. So probably more well suited to gathering, though. So a lot more ground food, such as small animals or vegetables or herbs, fruits, whatever we want to think of as like more ground based stuff. And being nocturnal and having the larger eyes, possibly they were more short-sighted, so their eyes weren't suited to longer distances, whereas Cro-Magnon had smaller eyes and was quite probably better over longer distances. And so the two of them, one is much more like a hunter and one is much more like a gatherer. And so the phrase hunter-gatherer, used to describe humans, is actually a hint at our true origin, the hybrid origin. And it's surprising that no one really notices it, but it's there in plain sight. Thank you.